Damn this traffic, man. Damn it, seriously. But you know what? The all-new Hero Xtreme 160R made through it. It kept it cool. It made me comfortable. It knew how to tackle that potholes. It was keeping its balance.
The all-new 160cc two-valve single-cylinder air-cooled engine, specially designed for good mid-range, comes with fuel injection, which is set up on the all-new chassis and frame. It is mated with a 5-speed manual transmission, which is really snappy in shifting gear, combinedly developing 15 bhp at 8500 rpm and 14 Nm of torque at 6500 rpm. It is enough to make your daily commute easy. Also, as it weighs almost around 140 kg curb, the power figure same good, as the engine doesn't have to carry more weight. And that feels easy in traffic, making it fun. The most important thing in this segment, and it's more interesting when your 12-liter tank is enough to cruise along the city, as it gives around 55 to 60 kmpl on highways and around 56 kmpl in city conditions. It has plenty of power to stop you with that old 276mm disc front brake and 220mm disc rear brake, which is optional, both by Nissan, which is also combined with single channel ABS. Although the front brakes could have been a bit more responsive to boost up the rider's confidence. And when it's about commuting, you need a good pair of tires and good suspension to soak up those potholes. Well, Hero did a fantastic job with that, giving alloys and a tubeless rubber of 100x80/17 front and 130x70 R17 rear with a 37mm dia telescopic suspension with anti-friction bush and a 7-step rider adjustable monoshock, which soaks up little potholes and bumps really easy, keeping the bike stable enough to push rider's confidence high and pushing the bike in the corner with good speed. This put this bike in straight competition with segment leader, the TVS Apache RTR 160 4V. I think enough of getting into spec sheets and the number game. Let's talk about the actual matter, the aesthetics and how it feels being on one. The complete LED setup really impressed me on my very first impressions. It surely grabs all the attention, and with three colors, it looks beautiful. And now, mentioning about the rider's triangle, it is exactly how it should be on a commuter. Not so aggressive, not so laid back, exactly to the point. Talking about the seat, there's enough support for the rider to stay in the saddle for long and not get tired. But the pillion stays a bit uncomfortable, as the cushion isn't that good. Also, the grab rails are a bit tricky to hold on to. Coming to the pricing, it's stated around ₹1,04,000 ex showroom for the base variant. At the end of the day, let us look at the complete package which Hero has on offer. I spent the entire Sunday on the saddle and it was comfortable. It treated me well and did the job perfectly. Although I missed the punch on the low end of the revs, but that's how commuters have to be, always about being in the mid-range. It has a kickstart if you need one someday. That's a good feature still continued. Talking about the weekend, it makes your ride fun on those twists as you open the throttle and there's a comfortable pull on offer which will keep your adrenaline high and smiles wide. Concluding, if I were to buy a motorcycle in this segment, which gives me a good economy as well as makes it fun and should look good, I would surely consider this one. That being said, see you soon with a new ride. Till then, keep riding. Signing off. Ciao.